We will leave discussions to the end of all sessions. The next talk is communication skills, and the speaker is well known to you all, Professor Omar Zaid, Professor of Medicine and Director of EDC, University of Khartoum.
When I was presenting this, I look at this list of the presentation, I thought, is it a teaching type of session or is it an information type of session? And I came to a conclusion, which we are going to share at the end. And from that I start. I haven't presented before a communication skill documentation as a presentation, but anyhow, I thought it's a very good exercise for me, and I hope if people got the same feeling of an exercise, then things will be better in the future. So, what is, if you took this one, the first slide is the slide which encompass whatever has been presented before. This is the CanMed, and in which you see that communication as part of the whole jargon of making a medical expert. And all of us were working in a situation where we are graduating students, when we are practicing medicine, and the two come together to us, and this is our life. So within that, I look at that type of things. And here, communication is part of it. Professional, as has been explained by Professor Sahal, and as a professionalism at the end. I saw that at the end we are profession. What is professionalism? And there are a lot of definitions, but I like this definition, which I copy and paste from different parts of the thing. That professionalism include not only medical knowledge and skills, which we have been using and practicing all the time. And on our medical schools, we are being doing with the medical knowledge, and we are being trained with the skills, and we examine students in the skills, short cases, long cases. At the end, we fail them, we make them available. But we have not looked at the other commitments to a set of shared values. And these commitments form the basis of a social contract between physician and society. We are graduating students. These students are going to work in a society. So this formation of society, there is a commitment. But this commitment have got a lot of shared values. These values are the values that has been not written in the curriculum, but they are part of the curriculum, the unwritten curriculum. Like you have heard the word like altruism. You are going to hear words like empathy, al-ta'atuf. You are hearing other words, and compassionateness, whatever it is. So it is a form of communication. And then I look at it in the literature. What are the communication competencies? A lot of problem, a lot of jargons, a lot of words that you may not have heard before. Concordance, mutual understanding, empathy, altruism, like has been said before, flexibility, interactiveness. Such words, such a lot of words. What about these words? A lot of words. Yeah, these are from different communication competencies, like this one. Do we need all these type of competence? Can we empower our students or ourselves? All these competencies, are there built in ourselves? So from those ways, I looked at communication skill as a communication skill. It is, when I look at it, to communicate effectively in a medical context. A human is a communicator, so communication everywhere. Tawasul anywhere. But it is a communication skill within the communicated effectively in a medical context. So we look to that point, and then we look at it, and then we found that communication skill, if we are going to communicate effectively, we need to communicate in certain areas. That we need to communicate in a patient and relative. And at the same time, we can add here society or community, as has been said clearly by Professor Ahmed, the examples, and by Professor Zain, the importance of a community to communicate through all these three parameters. You have to communicate with colleagues, you have to communicate in the legal authorities, and you have to communicate in a medical, in a media and press, and you have to communicate as a teacher. I think this will encompass all the roles of an importance for communication skills. So I looked at this in pieces, and at the same time, I'm going to look at it from my own perspective. of my medical encounters during my medical practitioner since I was graduated. So when I looked at the, when you looked at the communicate with patients and relatives, these are all the things that you need to know, or some of them. They may not be the all of them, but you have to answer questions, you have to give explanations, you have to look at difficult situations, how you have to break news, how we are going to break news to a person, how you are going to admit and acknowledge that you have been doing something wrong, or that you have made a mistake, or that you don't know. Yani these are part of the communication that were there. More like ensuring confidentiality, ensuring patience. When I looked at this type of, in this type, this component of the communication skill, and I look at it from my encounter as a medical student early when I was a house officer in Al-Ubaid. I was working as a house officer in the obstetric and gynecological ward. And at that time, to the professor, Dr. Usman, Dr. Hassanin was there. He was the senior obstetrician. And that was the case, and she was complaining of infertility, came with her husband. At that time, then he asked me in Arabic, I mean, under examination under anesthesia, and tell me, and call me, I will tell you if you have. أنا مشيت وعملت examination, كنت house officer وبعد ذاك لقيت ما عندها uterus, I couldn't feel the uterus. At that time, the ultrasound was not there. So, يعني في المبيت كانت devoid of ultrasound. He came, he confirmed my. بعد ذاك طلع بهناك جاني بعد جوية صحت, جاني زوجة قال لي أنت حاصل شنو؟ وجاء قلت له كويس بجيك بعدين أوريك نسأل الدكتور وأوريك. جيت للدكتور حسنين قلت له ها نعمل شنو؟ At that time I was just, يعني كانت my second shift as a house officer. قال لي أنا ما حأقول لك تقول لي شنو, لكن حأحكي لك قصة. قلت له أوكي. قال لي أنا زمان جاتني patient بنفس الطريقة دي. قال لي والله typical. وبعدين قال لي كانت في كوستي وعملت لها examination ولقيت ما عندها يترس. وقال لي زوجها كان يجيني في المكتب كثير ويطلع ويسألني والحاصل, بقول لي لسه. قال لي لما شفته متعاطف كده قمت حكيت له. قال لي يا اخي الزوجه دي بنت عمي وانا اقدر ان اوصل المعلومه دي لها, فارجوك ارجوك ما تكلمها, انا بكلمها. قال الموضوع خلاص ما جاتني وما جاني وخرجناه ومشينا. بعد ذاك بعد كم سنه قال نقلوه وين؟ نقلوه مدني. بعد كم سنه جاته المراه الزمان ذكرته قالت لي انت؟ قالت لي والله ما عرفني. قالت لي ما عرفتك. قالت لي يا اخي انت لو بتتذكر زمان احنا جيناك في كوستي وحصل كذا 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 وانت قلت لي كده. قلت لها قال لي انت قلت لي شنو؟ قالت لي قالت لي وانت قلت لي انا زوجي جا كلمني ما انت؟ قال لا والله انا زوجك بنتي قريبتي والدكتور قال انت ما عندك اي مشكله في الولاده لكن انا ما بلدي, فيعني انا قريبك لو يعني انت لو والله لو قعدتي معي وقلت داري تقعدي معي وانا اقعد معك انا ما عندي مانع لا بتزوج معاك لا بعمل زي تبيك الوصيه هسه. فقال بعد ما قال لي كده قال قلت له لا انا عاوز اتجنى زي جود دايفورس. والله ما انساه ابدا يعني زي جود دايفورس. يعني انا لما قعدت بعد ذاك وقال لي خلاص بعد امشي كلمه. والله ذيس واز هابين تو مي يعني 20 مور 20 ذان 20 ييرز باك. انا شعرت اكثر من 25 لما بدا يجلل الموضوع شويه. بعد ذاك بعد ذاك ما عندنا الناس يعني ما دارين نرفع الموضوع. فا اي صوت يعني ات ذات ذن اي بوت ات ان ذا كونتكست يعني ذات والله اي واز هي بوت مي ان ا فيري جود ليسون اند اي ستارت تو شو ات تو اذر بيبول. يعني اي صوت انه يعني ات ذات تايم اي صوت انه ذات بيرسون واز فيري يعني هيز ا فيري وايز بيرسون لانه هي اكسبتد ذا فاكت ذن هي بوت ذا فاكت هي ونت تو بوت هار اون ذا سيم تيست. اف شي اكسبت ذات تيست اند شي سيد يس اي لايك تو سبي ويز يو ماي لايف he wouldn't have done another thing. فبعد ذاك it was left to me. This is the second step. What should I do? Then I thought, أنه this fact is belong to that lady. He is married to her, لكن the right thing is up to her. عشان كده if he